We've actually talked mostly about turning a story into a play. And we did that, of course, with our Scooby-Doo story. And we picked a story about some scary monsters and a Mayan temple and things like that. But what we wanted to do was to make it our own story. So we decided to form our own gang. And we do have one character, of course. We had to have Scooby-Doo. So one of us did, and everybody voted on who would be Scooby-Doo. But we all had our own character name. So we talked a lot about character. We talked a lot about setting or set. And we turned setting into the set, literally. There it is. And we also talked a lot about the story arc, and we even got into rising action and climax, and we did not use the word denouement, but I wanted to.
Go for it.
But generally, they all caught on to that. These kids are just brilliant. I'm sure all of you know that. So we also had to, we also enjoyed infusing the whole musical theater aspect of this, which Miss Tara did because I have two left feet. So basically, we kind of split things up, working. So this story you're about to see is a story of their own creation, and a story that they pretty much decided on everything, including all of the artistic elements. But I think their favorite thing was making their monsters, which they get to take home today. Tara?
Sorry, I have a run to restroom. So thank you so much for being here. I think we're ready to go. Your children are wonderful, great sense of rhythm, and they're excited to show you their fancy new steps, the big smiling faces, and their loud stage voices. Right, guys? Okay. And with that, we're ready to set for the top of the show. So I'll take that call this way. This way.
What's wrong? Gotcha! We wouldn't have gotten away with it if it weren't of you meddling kids and that dog of yours.
Go listen.